local jazz groups and several extracurricular groups. Please welcome the Leboldus Choirs and MCs Owen Westerlund and Serafina Marcotte.
Hello, I'm Owen Westerlund, and this is Serafina. Anyways, so getting on with this. During the time of Advent, we prepare to celebrate the birth of Christ at Christmas and remember the story of that first Christmas long ago. In the town of Nazareth, there lived a fine carpenter named Joseph and his wife, Mary. One night, Mary had a dream. She dreamed of a beautiful angel who told her she would one day have a baby named Jesus. Soon afterwards, Joseph and Mary set out on a journey. Mary rode upon a gentle donkey while Joseph walked by her side. Joseph and Mary traveled under the day's golden sun and rested beneath the evening's starry light. It was late one night when Joseph and Mary arrived in the little town of Bethlehem. Joseph knocked upon the door of the inn, but there was no room. Joseph and Mary were led to a shepherd's stable, and by the cows and the sheep and all creatures great and small, Joseph made a fresh bed of hay. Then suddenly, beautiful angels filled the sky, and a great bright star rose over Bethlehem.
Thank you. fields, an angel of the Lord appeared to the shepherds who were tending their flock of sheep by night. The angel announced that the Savior had been born in the town of David. Suddenly, a great host of heavenly beings appeared with the angels and began singing praises to God. As the angelic beings departed, the shepherds decided to travel to Bethlehem and see the Christ child. There, they found Mary, Joseph, and the baby in the stable. After their visit, they began to spread the word about this amazing child and everything the angel had said about him. They went on their way, still praising and glorifying God. Far away in the east, three wise men had seen the beautiful star shining brightly above Bethlehem. The wise men knew that this was a sign from God and that they should follow the star. They traveled for days and days on a camel over the mountains, over deserts, and over wide open plains. But no matter what, they always followed the bright star in the sky, which finally stopped in Bethlehem. The wise men were overjoyed to have finally reached their destination. They entered the house and saw the little child with Mary. Knowing that Jesus was the Son of God, they knelt before him and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Visitors had left, and the Holy Family were on their own. Mary and Joseph looked down at their newborn baby and felt a sense of awe. It was such an honor to carry out God's divine plan. They know that their child will grow up and turn tears to laughter, hate to love, war to peace, and will bring nations together. What a wonderful gift that God gave the world. the birth of his only Son, so that we all may live an eternal life, that ray of hope for all mankind to follow.
Comes to pass when a child is born.
Let us remember that the good news of Jesus' birth has the power to bring us great joy this Advent season. Our joy is not dependent on what is going on in our life, in our world, or the people that we are with. It does not depend on the gifts we give or the gifts we find under the tree. Our joy comes from the wonderful gift God shared with the world. That joy that flooded the hearts of the shepherds, the angels, the wise men, the hosts of heaven, and Mary and Joseph is the joy that still has the power to overwhelm our hearts with rejoicing. Mary and Joseph believed and were able to feel the joy of holding baby Jesus in their arms. The shepherds and wise men believed the angels and the signs and experienced the great gladness of worshiping their Messiah. Flood our hearts with joy this Advent season as we go forth and proclaim the good news from the mountaintops.
Chair of the Regina Catholic School.